Good morning everyone, this is Karan Singh and today in this video we will see a topic of English grammar, that is future indefinite tense. This is tenses part 10. If you have not seen the previous parts, so first of all go and see them. If you have seen, then we continue with this video. Alright, so let us come to start. So first of all, we will see that where future indefinite tense is used. So future indefinite tense is used to express an action in future, means those actions which are about to be happened in coming time, in future time, those are written, those are translated in future indefinite tense. I hope it is clear. So future indefinite tense is used to express those actions which are happened in future or in coming time. There we use future indefinite tense. Let us see some example. As number one, he will go to Kanpur. So here going work will be done in future time. So that is why here this sentence, this work has been written in future indefinite tense. See the next example. Sita will sing a sweet song. So here singing work will be done in future time. So that is why this sentence has also been written in future indefinite tense. See the next examples. They will play cricket match. So here playing work will also be done in future time. That is why this sentence has been also written in future indefinite tense. I hope where future indefinite tense is used, it has been cleared to you all. If it has been cleared, so let us move to the next point of this tense. So here first of all, let's see some rules. Rules for future indefinite tense. There are a few rules in future indefinite tense. They are as following. Let us see them one by one. Number one, helping verb. So which type of helping verb we use here? So helping verb will and shall are used in future indefinite tense. Which type of helping verb? Will and shall. So these two helping verbs are used in this tense, future indefinite tense. Let us see that where we have to use will and where we have to use shall. So will is used with all subjects, all the subjects. So this helping verb will can be used with all kinds of subjects, whether subject is singular or plural. But shall is used with I and we only. So this helping verb shall is used with I when there is a subject. When subject is I or we, then we use shall. Otherwise, we use only will with all the subjects. I hope which type of helping verb we have to use in future indefinite tense and where it will be used with which type of subject it will be used, it will be cleared to you all. So let us see the next rule, that is main verb. So which type of main verb? I have already told you all what is main verb. So main verb V1 means first form of the verb is used in future indefinite tense. So this one, B1 means first form, V1 first form of the verb is used in this tense, future indefinite tense. What is first form? It is also known as a base form of the verb or infinity form of the verb, like go, play, sing, etc. So I hope it is clear which type of main verb is used in future indefinite tense. There will be, we will use first form of the verb, base form of the verb, like go, play, sing, etc. Now let us see the next point of this tense, structures. So structures for affirmative sentences. So which type of structures we use for writing, for speaking affirmative sentence? First of all, we use subject, and then after helping verb will or shall, then main verb that will be first form, and then other word including object. So here this sub structure will be used for affirmative sentences. First of all, we write subject, then helping verb will or shall, either will or shall according to subject, then first form, and then other word. I hope this structure has been cleared to you all. Let us see some examples of affirmative sentences. As number one, I shall read this book today. So here I is a subject, I is subject, then helping verb, shall is, here shall is a helping verb, read, this is a first form, this book today, these words are other words. So here I shall has been used because subject is I. We shall go to Jaipur with you. So here shall is a helping verb. It has been used because here we as a subject used, that is why shall has been used as a helping verb. See the next example. They will help you tomorrow. So here they subject will as a helping verb because there is a they, and help, this is the first form of the verb, you tomorrow. So these are other words. Let's see the next example. He will not come here from his village tomorrow. So he as a subject, will as a helping verb, come as a main verb, first form of the verb, and these all are other words. So these all are affirmative sentences, and here the affirmative structures has been used. So let us see the next structure, that is structures for negative sentences. So which type of structure we have to use for negative sentences? First of all, we have to write subject, then helping verb will or shall, and just after helping verb we have to use not, then first form, and then other word. So this is structure we have to use for writing negative sentences, or you can say for forming negative sentences. First of all, we have to use subject, then helping verb as a will or shall, and just after will and shall we have to use not, then first form, and finally other word. Let's see the example. Number one, she will not come here. So after will there is a not because this is a negative sentence. See the next example. We shall not help you. So after shall there is a not because this is negative sentence. See the next example. Ram will not write a letter today. So after will there is a not. Next, she will never go there. So here after will there is never. This is a negative word. So these all are negative sentences, and these all have been written with the help of negative structures. Okay, so let us see the next structures for yes no questions. So which type of structure we use for writing yes no type sentences? First of all, we use helping verb in the form of will or shall. According to subject, it will be used, and then after we have to use subject, and then not. If not, if there is a negative sentence in a negative sense in the sentence, then only not is used after subject. Otherwise, if there is not negative sense, then direct we come to first form of the verb, and then after other word, and finally this marks is used. So this structure is applied for writing yes no type questions. First of all, we have to use helping verb. Here helping verb will be use will or shall, then subject, then not. If not will be in the sentence, only then not is used. Otherwise we have to use first form of the verb, then other word, and finally question marks. Let's see some examples. As number one, will these children play here tomorrow? See, these are this example. First of all, this sentence has been started with will. This is a helping verb. These children, this is a subject. Play is a main verb, and here tomorrow as other verb. So there is no negative sense. That is why there is no not after subject here. Okay, see the next example. Will the peon not ring the bell today? So here sentence has been started with helping verb. This is a subject, and then after subject there is a not, because this is interrogative and negative sentence, and the rest are as following as the previous. See the next examples. Will she never go with me? So here sentence has been started with will. This is yes no type questions. See, this sentence is also started with the helping verb. Shall we not go to market today? So this is also yes no type questions. These all can be answered, because I have already told you all what is yes no type questions. Those questions which can be answered by yes or no can be called yes no type question. Generally these sentences are started with the helping verb in English. Let's see the next structures for WH question. And I have already told you all that what is WH question. So the question word, you know, which are actually which the sentence which is started with the question word, that is WH question, and also cannot be answered by yes or no. See the structures for a WH question. First of all, we have to use the question word, then helping verb. In here, helping verb will be used as a will or shall, then after subject, not. If not is in the sentence, then first form of the verb, other word, and finally question mark. So this is the structure for WH question. Question word, will and shall, subject, not, given, and other word, finally question marks. So let us see some examples. As number one, what shall we eat today? So this is a question word, this is helping verb, we as a subject, eat is a first form of the verb, and today as a other word. See the next example. When will you go home? So when as a question word, will as a helping verb, you as a subject, go first form, and home as a another word. How will he do this work? So how question word, will helping verb, he subject, do main verb, and other word. See the next example. Who will not wait for you? So who question word, there is no subject, because question has been asked on subject. So that is why after helping verb there is no subject, direct not has come, then first form and other word. So these all are the sentences of WH question. And here WH question has the structure of WH question has been used to write to speak all these sentences, or all these kinds of sentences. I hope everything of a future indefinite tense has been clear to you all. Thanks a lot for watching us.